It's the Gitty Gang Show on Starbucks Nation TV. It's the Gitty Gang Show on Cigarbox Nation TV. And we're coming to you live from CB Gitty. It's the Gitty Gang Show.
Gitty Gang Show.
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 It's the Gitty Gang Show on Cigarbox Nation TV.
Hey, welcome back to the Gitty Gang Show. Glenn Watt here. We got Mr. Nick Lanciano behind the producer's desk over there. And we are again this week trying out yet another permutation, another audio experiment. You see, there's no microphones in front of our faces. Glenn and I both have wireless lapel mics clipped on here. His battery is flashing a little bit low, but we hope it's going to make it through the show. So once again, everyone, let us know how it's sounding. I've got the sound box right here behind me. If you say I'm too loud and Glenn's too quiet or both too loud, I can try to fix it. I can fix it. I promise I can.
Nice.
Well, anyway, welcome to the 104th episode of the Gitty Gang Show.
Oh, yeah.
When I scheduled the broadcast earlier, I wasn't sure what the exact number was, but I have
that.
Since...
something.
100 and something. But I've since figured out that it is indeed the 104th show. Got some good stuff lined up for you today. A couple of videos. Got one from Eric Denton. We've got... a video from, I believe, a practice session, a band practice session down there in Georgia. Got J-Dub in there, some more. This is kind of the Eric Denton show I'm seeing from the...
The Dentoning. The Dentoning. That's awesome.
Tis a Dentoning.
Yeah, we have two videos from Eric.
Andy's in the third
Andy's
one,
in the
too.
Third one.
So, but that's all good. Hey, hey, we'll call it a theme.
Yeah.
Little background home is coming through. Is that what I heard? Hiss.
Cool.
Hiss coming through.
How bad is it?
Because
having to switch over at this point would really not be fun.
I don't know. Let us know how bad it is. And Mike, I don't know what kind of mics Ben's using. That was all Ben.
It's not a Sennheiser, I'll tell you that.
It sounds better now.
I didn't do anything yet. All right. Well, good. Maybe there was some sunspots.
It is mild. It's probably...
I don't know either. But anyway, we're going to run with it. Got a few tidbits to share with you. An article about Samantha Fish appeared in a paper back around my old stomping grounds in Northern Ohio. A song that I don't know if I know we haven't done it together before. I think I did. Anyway, it's a song I wrote a while back. It's a little bit different. It's not about Charlie Boyle, for one, but it's not about trains either. So we're going to be running that. Surprise visitor. Oh, no, it's the wind. The wind just blew the Juke Shack door open. That's all right. I don't mind a breeze because I'm wearing this sweatshirt up here. So, yeah. Also, of course, Walk Corner. Bump, bump.
Walk Corner. That was Wild Wild West.
All right. So to get started, just a few things. I talked about the new attempt at better audio. Hopefully, Dave just got here. We got to start over.
Pip Gatton.
Roll
hey!
Credits. No, I'm just kidding. The new sound, the t-shirt closeout that launched earlier this week. We've still got a few shirts left from that original round of designs. And I wanted to let you folks know, the closeout is that they are all marked down to $5, right? $5, regardless of size, style, whatever. I really want them gone. So there's a coupon code, shirts be gone, all capital letters, SHIRTSBEGONE. You get another 50% off, which brings the price per shirt down to like $250. So please make these shirts go away. I'm giving them away, people.
Are there any spaces in those words?
No spaces, all one word, shirts be gone.
All caps.
Should get you 50% off during checkout. Speaking of shirts, just yesterday I shipped a box out to our good buddy Jim Morris down there in West Virginia. He's been running Canjo seminars or Canjo workshops. You know about that, Glenn. Doing great work down there. He's posting photos. So I had a bunch of small and medium-sized shirts. And, of course, they don't sell very good. A lot of our people prefer a little bit bigger sizes. So I was like, what can I do with all these smalls and mediums? Well, it turns out, ship them all down to Jim, and he can give them away at his next Canjo workshop, which I think he said is in October. Mm. He's got another one coming up. So putting those shirts, hopefully, to a good use, make some kids happy down there in West Virginia. Speaking of folks down in the specifically the Southeast, we certainly are in our thoughts and prayers, all of those impacted by Hurricane Dorian, I believe is how it's pronounced. Dorian. Or Dorian. Whatever.
The picture of Dorian Gray?
Yeah, no, different Dorian. Different Dorian. But seriously, our thoughts are with you. I see Orlin Fordham out there. Hopefully your shirt will be shipping out soon, Orlin. It's kind of been sitting in awaiting production for a while. All of the new shirts are through a print-on-demand service. You can find all of them over at hobofiddle.com. I've been assiduously, is that the right word?
I don't know.
I've been busy adding all of the existing designs to hobofiddle.com, including that one, I know Michael Pinkerton liked it and some others liked it, the Cigar Box Guitars design. It's kind of understated and classy and hadn't been available on the cbgitty.com site in quite a while. And the listing was even gone. And then I found a few, relisted it. But yeah, all sorts of good stuff available. Sweatshirts, like I'm foolishly wearing on not that chilly of a day. T-shirts, tank tops, hoodies, also coffee mugs.
Coffee mugs.
Dave says, last week's mic sounded better. Problem is, it really, those mics tie you right down. So, well, we keep trying.
Well, they're saying it sounds a little bit muffled. I was going to mention it at one of the breaks, but they're saying it's a little bit
well,
muffled.
Well, part of that might be that I brought the treble all the way down because we were getting a little bit of a high-pitched whine. I'll bring it back up. Let us know if you hear a high-pitched whine besides...
Thank you, Dell, for the compliment on the shirts. And we were just earlier before the show began, we're talking about how it's how neat it is that some things that you see, like the panda, as the unofficial mascot of the Gitty Gang show, and Gitty Gangsters, like that term that you came up with, Del. You know, these are things that are community created, the viewer audience created, community created, and we're just stoked that we have that kind of fan base.
Yeah, well, community, family, community. Whatever you want to call it, friend group.
Friend group.
I've actually got a monologue on that particular subject coming up in the third half of today's show. So Philip's saying it's better. Okay, I brought the treble back up, but you're not hearing a high-pitched whine, I hope. I got a little bit of compression on there. I guess I could bring that down. Still fiddling with knobs and buttons, folks. It's all good.
Buttons.
It's what people like to see on a live show. All sorts of dead air and fiddling with knobs and buttons. And tuning.
No, it's not critical, Dave. We're looking for the feedback because Ben is trying to dial it in so we have a better audio quality. We're certainly better than we were with the webcam mic, so...
Oh, jeez.
You know, if you go back and watch
the old days. We've all become spoiled in a way, haven't we? But, all right, before we get into our first video, which is that band practice that J-Dub and Eric Denton and who else is in that shot? Scene Cruz?
I think Scene Cruz.
Nice. Well, I just wanted... this popped up in my Google alerts today. It's an article that appeared in a newspaper in Bowling Green, Ohio, which is not far from where I grew up. I actually spent time in Bowling Green during my formative years. But the headline of this article was Fish Returns to the Swamp. Fish returns to the swamp. Like, huh, that sounds interesting. And it was flagged for having Cigar Box Guitars in it. So the article talks about is that Samantha Fish, our own beloved Samantha Fish, probably the biggest name in Cigar Box guitar performances these days, at least on the blues side, she's headed back to the Black Swamp Arts Festival, which takes place every year there in Bowling Green, Ohio. Now, last year she was there, Oh, she's going to be the headliner this year, too, which that's a bit of a thing. Last year, the event got rained out, so what did Samantha do? Hauled all their gear into one of the nearby bars, set up and played a full set for about 50 people in that bar, and just rocked the house out, as she is wont to do.
So like she's still in it for just the music.
Well, yeah, it's, you know, she down in New Orleans, I wasn't there this past January, but the year before, I went, like, she hauled, you know, she didn't have her full crew with her, so she's up there setting stuff up, winding cables, hauling stuff in and out. Yeah, the real deal. And she has a new album coming out named Bulletproof, supposed to be out on September 20th, so a couple of weeks from today. And the word on the street is that she will once again this year be involved in the New Orleans Cigar Box Guitar nice. Festival coming up on January 15th through the 18th down there in exciting New Orleans, Louisiana. Often beautiful, sometimes smelly, but always fun, New Orleans, Louisiana. So here's just a brief excerpt from the article. Samantha Fish is known for her burning guitar solos. More than that, she is also a master on the cigar box guitar, which she uses on several songs. At last year's show, she also played a kerosene can guitar built out like the cigar box. And I wish I could remember who built her that kerosene can guitar. I think it's one of our friends. And then Samantha says, "It kind of makes a big cameo in my show. That cigar box guitar has a really particular tone, and it's very aggressive. It's got a real raw kind of quality to it. Yeah, so I just use it for all kinds of different tones. And then in the studio, I've got all my other guitars that I apply. And if I've got to have a Jaguar tone or a 12-string tone or whatever, she's got it nearby. But the cigar box guitar has its own personality that I kind of think attributes itself more to the Delta, kind of a Fat Possum North Mississippi sound, of which she was a big fan of as she was coming up and growing up," as she says. So Samantha will be on stage there at the Black Swamp Arts Festival, 8 p.m. tonight.
Hey.
That's happening this very day. So yeah, I thought that was pretty cool, seeing a little bit of Samantha Fish in the news. Yeah, buddy. All right. So now we've got that video for you we've been promising, the Eric Denton, Janice Wilson-Hughes, and Scene Cruz jamming out there. A little bit of band practice.
All right, I got a little Cranberries tune here for you.
Rusty actually took the effort to send in a series of much longer, actually two videos, a good bit longer. There was a lot more that went into that particular jam session, which I believe he's either already posted or we'll see if we can make available the whole thing if you want to watch it. But that was a nice excerpt there. It looked like they were having a good time. It was Cranberries song, right? We didn't have the audio on here. But
that was
yeah.
The Cranberries.
Cranberries, yeah. All right, so speaking of songs, here's one. Glenn looked at me yesterday or day before or whenever the heck it was. He's like, pick out one of your songs to do this week and don't screw it up.
I did say don't screw it up.
That's how he is. That's just how he is, folks.
Real terror off the
terror. Terror. So this is one that I wrote a while back, named it Doin Ya No Good, and it's kind of a different feel from most of what I've written. And hopefully the sound of the hobo fiddle, it looks like we're getting audio from it on there, so hopefully that comes through. It's not plugged into the box. Ready, Glenn?
I'm ready.
All right. The bass, give us a little bit of bassy bass there. Looks like the bass might be a little high. All right. Okay. And one, two, three, four. Pick up a book and put it down. Keep your feet flat on the ground. All this fussing and fighting, it sure don't do you any good. Be kind to the ones you love. Never push and never shove. You know that the good ones, they're a lot rarer than you might ever think. A step back and look around. What's that soft little sound? You know it's just time, always a passing you right on by. But always keep on keeping on. Take what comes and move along. You know all that worrying, it doesn't do you no damn good. There it is. So pick up that book and read it through. No one can do it for you. Fussing and fighting, it's still not doing you any good. It don't do you no good. All right, so there's original piece, Doin Ya No Good. Some of that I kind of try to live by myself, you know. Try not to worry too much. Don't be a jerk on purpose. And stuff like that. So
there was some saying that the bass was a little too low.
Too low.
A little too low.
Every time I try to get the bass right.
Take this opportunity to say hello to Tom Petrie. Good to see you, sir. Turtle Box Guitars. I see Nick Lanciano out there. Tim Henderson, Janice Wilson Hughes, Michael Capato, Janet Baker Hughes.
Hey, my Gitty.
Tom Petrie again. Hey, Slim Jim Burt, Roll Tide. You know the deal. Good to see you, Rusty Taylor.
Only a Jimmy Circle out there.
Hey, Jimmy.
Good to see you. That's my song. So
right.
Now we've got another video for you from Mr. Eric Denton, old man Eric Denton himself, showing off and talking about this is like an Eric Denton, Janice Wilson Hughes love fest here, ain't gonna lie, but he's talking about one of Janice's new tone bars that you saw me play a couple of weeks ago. The poor lonely lap steel is still sitting right over there. But yeah, here you go.
Howdy, folks. I'd like to share this tone bar here with you from Janice Wilson Hughes. Check that sucker out. This thing's got all the weight you like in a tone bar, but this thing just lays in your hand and it feels good. The tone is unbelievable. Nice, smooth, and creamy. Check it out. Thank you. Janice Wilson Hughes. These big bad Mamma Jamma tone bars ain't no joke. Check them out.
All right, that's some good stuff right there. I tell you what, Eric can play, man. It's nice to see somebody who can, for God's sake.
You can play, old man Denton. That's for sure.
I saw, I don't know exactly what was being asked, but possibly it was about the chords I was playing in that last song. And I just wanted to briefly say that song, I don't want to say jazzier sound, but, you know, that is one where I just kind of was noodling around, and I just kind of found some things that sounded good together. And kind of wrote some words to fit a progression I came up with just through noodling around and finding things that kind of work together. Now officially, it goes E to G sharp minor, to A, to E, and then up here to C sharp minor. But nobody cares about that. It's not as hard to play as it might look like. But anyway, just messing a boot.
Sounds
messing
good.
A boot, having fun.
Sounds good.
So I wanted to just briefly, I've got notes today, cue cards, like, you know, David Letterman used to, you know, the blue cards. Michael Capato, our good buddy Michael Capato, I believe it was last night, made a post on the Friends of CB Gitty group on Facebook talking about how great he thinks that this whole cigar box guitar, handmade, homemade music community is. And, you know, he's right. And I just wanted to jot down some thoughts about that. Basically talking about what a community this really is. Like I say, Michael was talking about how glad he is to be a member of this community. And I think what prompted him to make that post, beyond the single malt bourbon, I believe that might have been, at least partly, he posted that. I'm not making this up. Was that Marty Tauber, who of course is our good buddy who winds the Wicked Bucker pickups, shared with him some information, because Michael's getting into wanting to wind some of his own pickups, and Marty shared information with him freely. And it's, you know, the good people that are in the Cigar Box Guitar community, and especially in the Friends of CB Gitty group, I'll just throw that out there and say, you know, the generosity, the sharing of parts. One of our newer members there, Josh T. Duran, posted that somebody gifted him a bunch of parts. He's been happily building. People like Marty and many others sharing knowledge and how-to information. Sharing praise and kind words, you know, goes a long way, and encouragement. And there's few people that you'll find better at that than our friend there, J-Dubs. Janice Wilson Hughes is always there with a kind word. And if you should happen to order something from her directly, one of her slides, you know, there's usually a nice handwritten uplifting note in there. That's why I always like to be the one to open the box when it arrives, because, you know, first one to see it gets the magic. Another conversation that came up recently, I don't know if it was on the Friends of Gitty group or not, was about the world's smallest cigar box guitar. And Marty brought up that he had built a couple of very small cigar box guitars. This was back in 2014. Marty made a couple of, they're actually Christmas ornaments. Hey, the mic follows me up to the camera now.
What?
Believe that?
Oh, yeah.
There's one. And then he's got another one he did, and he gave them to us here at Gitty for the company Christmas tree. And then, you know, in 2017, our buddy Peter Davis kind of made a little ornament thing out of one of our laser-cut cigar box guitars. So, you know, just being reminded of the generosity and the you know, the good spirits of so many people out there in this community. Our good buddy Gary DeRosiers, who has gifted us quite a few, like everybody in this room, and Farley and my son, like, you know, he builds and gifts guitars. Yeah. Randy Bretz, when he sends stuff to people, he's always including extra bits, and, you know, the sharing and praise and encouragement. And it got me thinking, you know, it's really amazing in a lot of ways, and I've said this before, that as many different kinds of people from all sorts of backgrounds and viewpoints and worldviews, that come together in this cigar box guitar homemade music movement and manage to, for the most part, get along. It's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
There's occasional flare-ups and occasionally a butthole gets through the filters, but usually doesn't last very long. You know, anybody who comes in looking to make trouble gets shoved to the side pretty quick. So like I say, it's amazing so many different people get along as well as they do on Cigar Box Nation, especially on Cigar Box Nation. We haven't had a flare up there in a good while. On Facebook, I think it's easier for people to and, you know, get a little worked up. An example of sharing of knowledge, our good buddy Kenny Lee Burgess is a master blues musician. He's been a music educator for many years. And you've probably seen that recently in the Cigar Box Guitar Group, he has been starting to try to gently share some music theory, some fundamentals of music theory to get people talking and thinking about that and hopefully learning a bit from it. Because, you know, Kenny's point of view, which I happen to agree with, is it helps to be born with an ear, no question. That magical, like the Stevie Ray Vaughan ear. You don't read music, you never have, but you can just pick up anything and play it. That's nice, but it's also extremely rare. I wasn't born with it. I don't think Glenn would claim to have been born with it. So some combination, whatever combination that works for you, whether it's learning music theory, learning to read music, or it's entirely by ear, or some combination. For me, it's a combination. Although it's only recently that I've gotten to trust my ear more. You know, getting in my earlier playing, I was kind of tied to music notation. So Glenn's one finger lessons have certainly helped a lot of people get started making music. Hopefully some of the tablature I've done has helped as well. You know, it's about finding your own path. Is anyone?
Everyone's saying nice things.
Nice things.
Just people
That's
are being
what I'm
nice,
talking about
you know?
Here. People saying nice things. In talking about it, when Kenny has made his posts, there have been a couple of people who kind of were critical of him. Like, why are you putting that stuff here? You know, nobody wants music theory. And like, well, that's not true.
That's not
you
true.
Know, there's a lot of different approaches. There's a lot of different viewpoints and methods that people use. And not everything has to be for everybody. If you don't need or like or want that, then it's not hard to scroll past.
Keep scrolling,
without,
man.
You know, you don't have to dump crap on it before right. you scroll past.
Keep scrolling.
Do what makes you happy. If you're having fun, you're doing it right. Provide advice and knowledge and encouragement, but try not to get bogged down in condemnation or being a purist or this way's right and that's way it was wrong. And if you're not doing it this way, you're not doing it right. That's not how I operate, you know? Build what you play what you love, and if you're having fun, you're doing it right.
You are doing it right.
This is an awesome community of people.
Yeah, it is.
Where are we going from here?
I don't know, what you got next? By the way, it is good to see you, Johnny Wick. We know, I know who you are, but it's good to see you, Johnny Wick. If only you were really John Wick, that'd be pretty cool.
I hear the corner coming. It's coming round the bend, and Glenn Watt, he's sitting here with his little grin. I don't know, I didn't think that through, but it is time for Watt Corner.
It always creeps up on me.
Did we find the graphic?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
All right.
I don't need to be on screen for this.
Oh, nonsense. Please keep him on.
No.
Yes.
Take him away.
Oh.
I don't want to fix it to put the guns.
Welcome back to Watt Corner. Good. It's good to see you here. First up, we have Mick, who happens to be on your perspective on the furthest away from me, the guy in their full red shirt.
It's the same.
Stage right, left.
On the right.
All right, stage right. Or that's...
They're seeing what you're seeing,
on the right. That is Mick. And Mick and his wife, Jean, and good friend, Larry, who you see in the tie-dye, were at the Pennsylvania Cigar Box Guitar Festival. And this is a picture of them. They're all holding guitars built by Mick. And Mick states that he had started building with simple stick-on-box designs, but thanks to the CBG community, he's been able to expand his builds. And I think there's going to be a couple things that were unplanned that are closely related between what Ben has talked about, what Nick has spent a bit today, and what I'm about to talk about as well, is just the amazing amount of work that it may not seem like work to you, but the amazing amount of work that you do and that everyone in this community does to make everyone else feel included and to learn and to grow. And I'm not going to beat this dead horse, but I am so stoked that you all do that. So thank you very much for all being here. And thank you, Mick, for sharing this photo with us, because I really like seeing smiling people connected with other smiling people at a Cigar Box Guitar Festival, especially that one in New York, which I'm sorry I missed, but I'm glad to know that everyone there enjoyed the pants off it. So thank you, Mick. And next up, we have for you another good photo of Gordon El Gordo. Gordon, I don't know if you're just going to be a bit of a surprise here. So I was Cigar Box Nation t-shirt. You can probably tell the top of the logo there, the Cigar Box Nation t-shirt. And this was taken at the beautiful thing. That you see El Gordo holding is one that he sold that day at the Beautiful Days Music Festival over there in Devon, United Kingdom. So thank you very much, Gordo, for sharing that. If you haven't seen already, if you particular who watching haven't seen, Gordon's actually posted in the Friends of CB Gitty Facebook group, the Friends of Gitty group, some ukuleles and an audio clip of his ukuleles. I highly recommend checking them out. They're really good stuff. So thank you very much, Gordon, for sharing that with us. Next up, we've got Andrew V. I just had it. They're people pictures, man, and I love seeing people out there. So this is Andrew V, and he's playing his guitar. But in the next image that Andrew V shared with us, you'll see the interior of his recent Cigar Box guitar build, and it's these springs. Now, I know for a lot of you, this is probably likely not a new idea. Don't hit the microphone, Glenn. I haven't tried it myself. And of you out there who have or have not seen it, have you tried this? Just hooking up springs, especially on the side of the neck, to give your acoustic Cigar Box guitar some reverb. It's really not that, even though I haven't done it myself, I can tell you just by sight, it's not that difficult. And if you would like some direction on it, I know that Del Puckett, who I think is out there, the Giddy Gangsters originator of that term, Del Puckett has an amazing YouTube channel. If you haven't seen it, please go check out Del Puckett's YouTube channel. I think it's Puckett Cigar Box Guitars. But I believe he does a tutorial on how to install springs to have reverb on an acoustic CBG. Michael Capato, who I think is out there, I think he's also done something similar, at least in image and text. But I think this is a really cool idea, and I've been playing an acoustic CBG at home, and I know I got to add some springs to it just to kind of give it that little bit of wetness, that oomph that you hear, that you know oftentimes you hear on an effects pedal, but you can just do for real time. Good stuff on your own CBG. So thank you very much for sharing that with us, Andrew. I don't know if you're out there, but I hope you are, dude. Next up, what do we got? Next up, Burton. Bert, I don't know if you're out there. I do hope that you get to see this, though, because I was so psyched when you shared this with us about you. The image is kind of big now, and that you don't have to change it. This is one of Bert's Blues Box guitars, his license plate guitar. And about it, he writes, "I love the look of CB Giddy's license plate resonator, so I decided to make my own, however, more to his specs." He used a CB Gitty pre-fretted walnut neck for the first time. So he didn't make his own neck, and this time he used a pre-fretted walnut neck from us and some gold half moon tuners on this particular build, which is a gorgeous build. And I also love the fact that he's got a ton of license plates in the background on reserve for his next builds, which is pretty cool. Now, in the next image, what you'll see is, Bert writes about it, this license plate guitar also has my second ever hand-wound pickup with a disc piezo, however, set into the neck as well, but this is his hand-wound pickup. Now, this kind of relates to what Ben was talking about earlier and what I want to get a little bit more into. I want to put a pin in this. This is Bert's hand-wound pickup, which is awesome. Now, Bert cites Martin Tauber, who winds the Wicked Buckers, as being a giving, generous, gracious man who actually helped Burton get involved in winding pickups, because he sold Burton his first sewing machine to wind those pickups. And although Bert has no interest in marketing or competing in making it a job to wind pickups, it's just a hobby for him. But his willingness to share, like Martin's willingness to share and to grow together as a community, is his favorite part of being in the Cigar Box guitar community. And like Ben had already mentioned, Michael Capato had also cited in the Friends of Gitty Facebook group, had also cited Martin Tauber as being a stalwart and true community member, because in his post, Michael Capato wrote about his loving the cigar box guitar community in general, that he's moved to write that post to acknowledge and publicly thank Marty, because after reading a post that Michael had on his own winding pickups where he shared everything that he had about it, Marty didn't come at him with, hey, you're doing it wrong, or stop stepping on my toes, I'm selling these things, why are you undermining me? No, Marty went to him with just some advice. Just say, hey, here's some helpful advice. Maybe you'd like to try this on your next windings so that, maybe you'll find some improvements in your pickups. And Michael was gracious, publicly thanked Marty. Burton Philbrick did the same. This isn't just a Marty love fest. The point is that everyone out there is helping one another, and I'm really impressed by that. So thank you all for being just so gracious and so kind. So thank you. And next up, we got Poker Steve. I just recently connected with Poker Steve. I hope that you're out there, Poker Steve. And he regularly shares bills to our website that I'm happy to post there. This one in particular is a license plate build. As you can see, what I really enjoy is this is the first that I've seen of Poker Steve relicking. I'm going to use that as a verb, to relic something to make it look old. He relicked this license plate guitar. He used, you can see there, a little thin strip, that bridge and saddle. That's actually a Rail Runner, CB Gitty Rail Runner electric bridge. So there's a rod piezo underneath that brass saddle, and Poker Steve just cut the bass down so he could better fit it onto his license plate, just modifying something that already worked, but for his particular needs, he got it from us. I think it's awesome. He connected that rod piezo embedded bridge to that preamp that you see on the side. It gives a superior tone to electric acoustic guitars. If you haven't tried it, I highly recommend it. I think Poker Steve does a great job, and this relicking treatment that he uses is outstanding. And then the next image Nick has for you, you'll see the tuners. I don't know how he did it, but he took some chrome seal gear tuners of ours that he bought, so now they're his, and then just made them look old. And I just, I love that kind of stuff. I love taking brand new things and just making them look the way that you want for your particular piece of art. And great job, Poker Steve. I'm glad that I got to connect with you, and I hope that you enjoy seeing your stuff up here, because I know I do.
Yeah, because if they were still ours, it'd be really awkward to try to get them to get that shine back to the chrome before sending them back. It's like, hey, we need those back now.
That's right. That's right. Last up, we got from our man, Rusty Taylor. Come on now, Rusty. I wanted to share this because, and you can cycle through these images as you want, Nick. This is a build that Rusty did in collaboration with Alan Bieber of Copper Cigar Box Guitars. And this collaboration cigar box guitar, which you can see the graphics on it, are actually for the third annual Georgia Cigar Box Guitar Festival coming up in September. But you can see Rusty's under box neck design that he for using up with a thin box. But this is a collaboration guitar, like I said, between Alan and Rusty, and the benefits go towards 50-50, go towards one half goes towards the Georgia to help the Georgia Cigar Box Guitar Festival this year, and the other half goes towards the Henry Players, which are a performance arts theater, totally run by volunteers, entirely run by volunteers, a performance art theater in McDonough, Georgia, which I think is where the Cigar Box Guitar Festival is. So between Rusty and Alan, they made this guitar. It's up for auction right now. It's over $300, and I'm just really psyched that people come together to do something, and then to offer it to the community, and the proceeds of which are going to two really good causes: a volunteer-focused performance arts theater and a cigar box guitar festival. And I don't know how you can add more humanity to a thing than that. So really cool stuff. If you have the opportunity, I hope that you can make it to the Georgia Cigar Box Guitar Festival. It's September 28th. And support both, if you can, support both the Henry Players and the festival by bidding on this particular guitar, which the bidding will end the 28th, which is the day of the festival, and will be awarded to the winner. Thank you. This has been There's a lot of stumbling
fine,
there.
Fine-looking guitar. Yeah. I think I'd bid about Tree Fitty.
Hey, see?
Tree Fitty. All right. Well, thank you for that, Glenn. That is... only 40 after the hour.
Nice. Doing all right.
What else you got?
Oh, I got a...
All right, we ain't got much left.
Oh, how about a song? How can we not know a song? How about Mama Tried?
Oh. Yeah, all right. In D?
D? All right.
I just put a new nylon string on this. The low G string on this is a wound nylon string with that silver wind. And using those on, these are medium frets. It wears out. The winding starts coming undone. And I was saying to Glenn, I might want to try like a wide or a medium low or something to, or a narrow low to try to wear out my strings less. Oh boy, put me on the spot.
I don't.
Requests, everybody.
First thing I remember knowing was a lonesome whistle blowing and a young boy's dream of growing up to ride on a freight train leaving town, never knowing where I'm bound. No one could change my mind, but Mama tried. First and only rebel child from a family meek and mild. Well, Mama seemed to know what lay in store. Despite all my Sunday learning, to the pad I kept turning till Mama couldn't hold me anymore. And I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could change my mind, but Mama tried. Mama tried, Mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. Leaves only me to blame, 'cause Mama tried. Old Daddy, rest his soul, left my mom a heavy load. She tried so very hard to fill his shoes. Working hours without rest, wanted me to have the best. She tried to steer me right, but I refused. And I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one would steer me right, but Mama tried. Mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. Leaves only me to blame, 'cause Mama tried. Hey, leaves only me to blame, 'cause Mama tried.
Wow.
Sorry for messing up the bass.
Pulling that one right out of the back compartment, you
that
could
was
say.
Fun.
What chord was I, is it there, B minor in there?
There is a B minor, right. Yeah, in place of that.
I didn't go to the B minor, folks. Ain't gonna lie. So I just want to remind you, the remaining shirts, the T-shirts that we have here at CB Gitty, the last of the last of the non-print-on-demand ones, I'd marked them down to $5 earlier in the week. Got a coupon code right now, shirts be gone. All capital letters, all one word, S-H-I-R-T-S-B-E-G-O-N-E. You add them all to your cart, you mash that coupon code in during checkout, and it'll take them down to 50% off of the $5, which is literally
giving it away.
$2.50 yes. Each. Or as Glenn says, giving it away. Dell says he can hear the bass now. Give him a little schlippity schlap on there, Glenn. What? Yeah,
there
buddy.
It is.
That's what I'm talking about. So buy out the rest of the shirts. There's still a few of the larger, like I know there were a couple 5Xs. Couple of 4Xs, some 2Xs, and then a pretty good slew of larges, I believe. Still available. You get them, use them for shop rags or something.
Oh,
you know,
gifts.
Whatever. Gifts. That's it.
Or incentives to buy a guitar at a festival, that kind of thing.
Helen says it sounded all right. Thank you for letting us know. It's hard to be sure.
Yeah.
We're up here just kind of. I can see the audio bar on the monitor behind the camera. But knowing exactly where levels, you know, it's a thing. But hey, we try. This is DIY.
There's a lot of moving parts.
DIY TV. Yeah. A lot of knobs and buttons back in this area. Nick's over there mashing about.
Now, I see out there the...
there's a lot of buttons in this room.
A lot of buttons. Thank you, Kirk. Thank you, Janice, both. Seriously. Somebody asked about a list of upcoming Cigar Box Guitar Festivals. The only ones that I know of... Wim, who was out there earlier, I believe there's a festival in the Netherlands coming up. There's a festival in Germany coming up in September. But
we need to get him on our list here.
Yeah.
Although, I mean, he does better at remembering than I do.
But the Georgia Festival is September 28th. That's coming right up. And,
Kirk has a good point. That super special coupon code whoop-de-doo deal I just mentioned is on cbgitty.com. Trying to get rid of all of the shirts from CB Gitty, and then if you want one of the new ones, like a sweatshirt or a hoodie or a tank top, or even got some flip-flops.
What?
Cigar Box all Nation right. Flip-flops. I ain't kidding. I need to get a now that summer's over.
Yeah.
I clearly need to get myself a pair of flip-flops. Got some baby onesies on there, youth and kid-size shirts and hoodies, women's shirts, you know, cut and fit, especially for women. All sorts of great stuff on there. Hobofiddle.com. I just got the Cigar Box Nation logo, the color one, not the weathered one. Actually, both are on there now, to be honest. I just started this morning working on the Sawdust is Man Glitter line of shirts. Yeah. Hasn't been one of our most popular ones, but hey, why not? We got the design. And then the blue Voodoo Boogie, or just the Voodoo Boogie skeleton. Gonna have that on there and a whole range of colors and such beyond just blue. And for the t-shirts, I'm trying and for each of the designs to do both a basic that's like $12.99 for a t-shirt, a little bit more for the big sizes, and then a premium which has a broader range of colors. But the basic one's kind of like, I believe that's what this is. It's available in like black, navy blue, and dark gray. Mm. And $12.99, which for a custom printed print on demand shirt, that ain't too bad, I think.
What was the code again?
Shirts Be Gone, SHIRTSBEGONE, all caps, no spaces.
Can you use it in a sentence?
And remember,
you missed a B. Actually, I did it so that both coupon codes will work if you have BE or just the letter B. So
nice.
Because I figured some people might type it like Nick did. sorry, what was the other question?
I don't got anything.
I got nothing.
Kenny Bakeithley, it's good to see you. It's not a name I recognize.
He's from Scotland, right?
Hey!
Isn't he over in Scotland? We've seen him before.
Have you? I'm sorry.
Oh, sure. So, you mentioned a couple of European festivals coming up. Of course, we've got the Georgia International. What?
The R is important. Shirts Be Gone.
When I was spelling it out, I had to be very careful to get that R in there. We've got the Georgia International Cigar Box Guitar Festival, the fourth annual, I believe.
Where?
Third. Fourth?
Texas?
No, Georgia.
Georgia. Third.
Third annual. Sure? Yeah.
I'm
third.
Confident.
Georgia. McDonough, Georgia. Coming up on September 28th.
Yeah.
They're all trying to talk me into getting down there. Not just me. They'd probably rather you go
probably
down.
Not rather.
Probably rather see out. This guy and leave Ben
Rusty,
at home.
Rusty was kind enough to point out that Texas has got one coming up in November.
Oh, I did. There's actually two. Mark Caples, who organized the original Republic of Texas Festival, posted recently that there are two Texas festivals, one in the Hill Country and one in Houston area. Whoever knows more about those, shoot us an email.
Three.
Specifically this guy. Shoot Glenn an email, gwatt@cbgitty.com, with
one.
Festivals and events and stuff, and we will talk about them.
Yeah.
But there's a lot going on here at Gitty, and if people don't specifically send us information, it doesn't always make it onto the lineup, so let us know. Louis says, need a shop apron. There is an apron offered by this company, but it's only embroidered, so I've got to do a special art file for embroidery, which is different from screen printing, so hopefully we'll be able to get an apron, at least a basic apron of some sort, into the lineup soon. So go over to hobofiddle.com and check it out. A lot of good stuff on there. More every day, turns out.
Yeah.
And I've explained it before, but the reason it's on a separate site is that there's so much stuff on cbgitty.com that it kind of gets lost. And I thought a separate site with a distinctive name, hobofiddle.com, as the one place for all, kind of like a micro store in a way, for all of the clothing and accessories and that kind of thing. All print on demand, wide range of stuff. Kirk Otto brings up Steve Arvey. Just spoke with Steve Arvey earlier today. Was gonna write it on the script, forgot, but so thank you, Kurt. Kirk, Steve just recently got back from Australia. If you don't know, Steve Arvey is involved in the American Cigar Box Guitar Association. He's a blues musician, has been for many years, and it just fell in love with the Cigar Box guitar a few years back. And he was doing a tour over in Australia and ran into some Cigar Box guitar builders, and says that as some of you who live over there know, that the CBG FIVA is running hot down under.
Oh yeah.
Yes, that guy.
Talk to a lot of guys down there from Australia.
Well, we ship an awful lot of stuff
to
Australia.
And New Zealand.
Yep. Tasmania. On occasion.
Yeah.
Van Diemen's Land, as it was
Van
formerly
Diemen's
known.
Van Diemen's Land, indeed.
But in another week or so, Steve Arvey is headed down to Colombia. in South America to do a series of workshops. He worked with Glenn and got Glenn connected with the people down there. We shipped a whole slew of kits down. They're going to be building and playing cigar box guitars in Colombia with Steve Arvey down there guiding the whole thing. It's going to be great stuff. And you know, that it's, I don't remember exactly what country the garbage dump orchestra
I don't either.
Videos came out of. Was it Ecuador or Venezuela or Guatemala? I can't remember. Guatemala, of course, being in Central America, but you know, there's been a tradition of homemade musical instruments down there for much longer than we've been at it. But to be able to, for Steve to be able to do some cigar box guitar workshops down there, pretty cool stuff. Yeah. Oh, you got Nick talking about the fiddle, huh? I had the fiddle, Jim Morris's fiddle, down off the wall earlier.
That's great.
That would not be great with this lapel mic. I don't think that would work, folks. You'd get a whole lot of fiddle really quick.
It'd be a whole different show.
A new show, folks. Tune in next week. So, yeah, good stuff. And then, of course, as I mentioned earlier, in January of 2020, 15th through the 18th, the fifth annual New Orleans Cigar Box Guitar Festival. Down there on Frenchman Street in the Big Easy. Yeah, it's going to be good times. All sorts of great stuff going on. But unfortunately, we have no more great stuff to talk to you about today. So.
Oh, we can keep talking.
Oh, jeez. God help us all. I think my G-string has slipped again, folks. Send that one out to Bob Cusack.
The late and great.
Late and great. Well, it's the Gitty Gang Show on Cigar Box Nation TV. Say the Gitty Gang Show on Cigar Box Nation TV. And we came to you live from CB Gitty. Hat tricks, and if we don't see ya, don't know what we'll do. Some strings and at least one finger, I'd say.
Yeah.
And put them together, you know they're gonna ring. It's the Gitty Gang Show.
Gitty Gang Show.
It's the Gitty Gang Show.
Gitty Gang Show.
Yeah, the Gitty Gang Show.
Gitty Gang Show.
It's the Gitty Gang Show. Oh, oh.
Gitty Gang Show.
It's the Gitty Gang Show on Cigar Box Nation TV. Keep it going, Glenn Watt.
Thank you all very much, by the way.
Bass solo.
Is that what this is coming down to? Oh, on the pressure.
There you go, a little bit of bass solo there, guys.
Snap at the bass.
That's all we got. We'll see you again next week, everybody. Thanks for playing along.